This is the 2024 BMW i7 xDrive 60, and this is the ultimate tour. Hey everybody, it's Tom from Vehicle Visionary. Today, Carrie and I are at Orr BMW, and we're gonna give you the ins and the outs on this i7. We're gonna focus more on the interior than we are on the exterior, but there's still a lot to talk about here. If you want to buy this model or anything else they have here at Orr BMW in Shreveport, Louisiana, check out the link down in the description of the video. Let's dig in and get started. And I'm going to start right here on the front end with the headlight design. And let me do one thing here. Y'all are gonna get to see this. This is Carrie's favorite feature, and I wanna get the look on his face when I say that, because he loves the headlight design. In fact, he wants to know if he can change these out on his 7 Series and have this split look. What do you think about that? I'm actually being very facetious, because he doesn't like that. But some of you might and say, hey, I really like what BMW has done with this split headlight design here. We've got our daytime running lights and blinkers and all that stuff up here. And here's something that just kills one of the wives' tales on BMWs, if they don't come with blinkers. Uh-oh, I just told on a lot of you drivers out there. We've got to have some fun here. And hopefully the guy who said I should stick to reviewing Fords and Chevys is watching. That's right. As far as the design goes here, I have to say my favorite thing is this outline around right here. You can see that really well because we have an overcast day here, so we don't have that bright Louisiana sunshine kind of ruining some of what we can see, at least outdoors. We do have active air curtains right here. I don't know how easy it is for Carrie to get you a shot right there where you can see through, but there is daylight there, so you know that you're getting air flowing through that area, improving aerodynamics. Obviously, your more traditional look here, even though this is the i7 with the double kidney grille, we're gonna have our BMW logo up here. Loco, we're not in Mexico, are we? Logo. And gonna have a lot of gloss black here, but you know what? I think it works, because that works with elegance. And for people who say, I don't really like chrome that much, well, there's a good option for you. Obviously, an all-wheel drive model. Tire size on the front, we're going to have 255 on our width. We're going to have a 40 series sidewall, and wrapped around the 21 inch wheels. I have to say, a lot of EVs have some rather cheesy looking wheels. Not so much here. And as is typical with a lot of BMW models, we won't be able to show you everything as easily here, but here's what we have on the back. 285 on the width, a 35 series sidewall, and wrapped again with those or around the 21 inch wheels. And as we work our way up, side view mirrors, everything you would expect to find here, turn signal indicators built in. Obviously you've got your cameras down here, gonna be on both mirrors. They're heated, they're power adjustable, they're power folding. They are literally everything that you want. And we'll work our way back here to the rear. A little bit of that sport look here, because you've got the spoiler, the gloss black spoiler back here. That definitely helps out to give it a little more of a sporty flair. I'm glad that that's not too big, not overpowering. That's a good thing. So we also have our xDrive 60 logo right here. And one thing that you might also be interested in as we finish things up back here, we'll take a quick look at the remote. So you have remote start and some controls there on the side as well. A nice light remote, but it has a nice look to it. A combination of the silver and the gloss black. I think BMW did pretty well there. And how about the numbers that a lot of you want? Well, first of all, we're gonna open the hood and show you what's going on here. We'll give you a nice look underneath that huge plastic cover. 536 horsepower. And how about your charge times? On a level one charger, 1.9 kilowatts, we're looking at 47 hours. You might not want to do that. Level two charger, 22 kilowatts. We're looking at between 3 and 6 hours, but if you go with a DC fast charger, you're talking about less than 28 minutes. That is definitely going to be your best option. And let's go over here real quick, show you something that's pretty cool. You can walk up here and push that button right there and the door will open. Now give it a second, it opens a little bit more. In fact, it opens all the way if you're standing in the right place. And let's see what we have here with our numbers. So we're looking at 86 MPGEs. City, 91 highway, 38 kilowatt hours per 100 miles driven combined, and your average will be 88 mpge's. Now, while we're here, let's work our way back over to the, in fact, I'll do it from right here first. We got a couple of extra things to show you here. So I'm gonna do this and we'll walk over here. A little bit easier to do it from this side because I don't have all our stuff sitting there. I'm gonna hit this button one more time. We'll get more into the technology end of things. I'm gonna let that door open a little bit more. There are multiple ways to close this door or to open it. In fact, if I get inside, let me do it from right here. If I want to close the door, here's an option. I can just go like that. There we go. Want to make it look right. And then I'm going to swipe my finger back across to open the door. That worked a little bit better. You can also use the button right here if you want to do that. There are a multitude of ways you can open this door. And the cool thing about it is that this door actually does sense if somebody's standing here or if their arm is in the way. It'll actually come right up to your arm. In fact, I'll show you real quick. Watch this. It's gonna come right up to my arm and then it just kind of stops. Doesn't slam your arm in the door. So if you ever are talking to someone and you have your hand in there, well, that might not feel too good when the door comes right up to it, I don't know, but it doesn't actually slam down on your hand.
So let's talk about the trunk area of this vehicle, what it can tow, and what the trunk space looks like on the inside. The i7 xDrive 60 can tow up to 2,000 pounds. I wouldn't tow with it if it was mine, but if it's yours and you want to, up to 2,000 pounds is what you can tow. It has trunk space of 11.3 cubic feet. If you want to get into the trunk, there's a button right here. To press that button right there, the trunk opens. Also, I'm going to show you the other way to get into the trunk. You can close the trunk here with the usual button that most cars have, but you can also swipe to open also. Let me see if I can get this to work the first time. And there it goes. It flashes to let you know, and it opens. You have a little bit of storage space down here underneath the floor for your battery cables, which are in this bag. There's nothing underneath there. You have space here for a first aid kit, which is already there. Oh, there's actually there's a pump in there. It says first aid, but I don't see a first aid kit in there. A little bit of storage here, floor mats. There's a pass-through in there to get to your back seat. We'll show you that from the inside. And a couple of tie-downs for stuff that you might want to put in here. There's also the handle here for in case you get locked in the trunk. You can pull that and get yourself out, and a couple hooks here to hook things onto, whatever that may be. There's not a whole lot going on back here in the trunk. That's what you get. There's a little, what is this, BMW assistance. And there's nothing there. It's a little door that goes to nothing, if you like that thing. There's your button to close the trunk and lock it, and there's your button to just close the trunk because you want your trunk closed. And there you have it for storage, usability, and towing for the BMW i7 xDrive 60. Ultimate tour, all right? So we're just gonna hunt and peck our way through a lot of this stuff because this is, I think this is first for me for sure. I like this car features-wise, not split headlight-wise, but I wanna start with, before we get inside to do things, show you this soft closed door feature. I'm gonna go ahead and open the door up and then let Tom film the soft closed door part. So it does have soft closed doors. There you go. Okay, so let's go ahead and ultimate tour this. I'm gonna press this button and watch how it will open and give me access, because don't forget when I do these videos, I'm rich, so why should I open the door myself? That's for peasant people. Carrie's not a peasant. Let's get on inside here. And let's go through the tour here. Nice, comfortable back seat. It does have reclining seats, forward, backward, headrest, and your back part does go forward and backward also. We have a little slot here for features that you can add. You clamp things in here, television screens, coat hangers, or whatever you need in there. This doesn't do anything. It's just a design feature. I guess it's just there to look good, and it does. The television on the ceiling, we'll hunt and peck our way through showing you how to lower that in a little bit. There is a seat pocket. I called it a seat pocket this time. A lot of times I call it a door pocket. I don't know why, but I just do. It's a seat pocket today. There's one on the passenger side also. You also have vents for air conditioning. On the center console, there are vents for air conditioning, but as far as controlling the air conditioning, that's on the screens that are on the door. We'll get to that, but you can control your vent direction here on and off, and There's also a little pocket down here for storage. It's not wireless. It looks wireless, but it's not. So we're gonna shut this door. We're gonna push the button right here and let the door close itself for me. Again, because I'm rich, why should I close my own door? It's a lot of work to reach out there and pull a door shut when I can afford to buy a car that does all these features for me. There's also another button here I wanna show you on the door. If you press that button, the door won't open, but it will pop. From that point, I've gotta become a peasant and push it. But then I can push my rich people button again and the door will close itself. And one more, if all the power in this vehicle goes out and you need to get out in an emergency, there's another latch right here that you can pull, the mechanical latch, and it will let you come out without any power at all. On the door here in the back, you have your window button. Push that and the window closes.
Did it just close?
It's closed. The window did not close, people. The window opened. So push that button and it opens the window. And if your shades are up, then the shades will go down also as the window goes down. And you pull that button and the window goes back up.
It's opening now.
Yeah, it's actually closing. Ignore Tom, people. Ignore Tom. I'm teaching him how to be a better cameraman. So the door lock, unlock button's right there. On the door is the screen that you never use all these features with. We'll go over that also. Let's go over the center console right quick on the back. There's a button here that you push to extend that out. It's not power, it's just pressure or spring or whatever. It's not a power button. There's a wireless charger right here on the top, and there are cup holders right here. Inside, we have a little bit of storage, two USBs right there. I'm kind of surprised there's not more USBs back here, but this, you can use a third seat back here, but that hump is kind of big right there. And then you just simply pull this back. There's no screens or anything right there. You can lift this up. And then this is the latch you pull to lay it back down. So again, not power, just pressure or spring. There's a cover here you pull off and a little door you open, which gives you pass through to the trunk. Maybe there's a refrigerator option for this. That would be a nice thing to have. On this door, because the door feature, you have a screen on this door. It's kind of, there's a lot of glare here. So let me try to see if I can show you this and try to see if I can show you how to lower that television also. Swipe up here. You have a menu screen on here. You have some options, Fire TV, telephone, display for the television, my modes for your things that you want to pick for yourself, and your seat adjustments, your blinds, and your interior lights, and your temperature control. Even though your vents are down here, you actually control your temperatures and things from here, including your seat temperature and your temperature on your three-zone climate control. For, let's go to the display, which is what people are probably more interested in. You press that button right there. Your theater option comes up, and you can see there's an image of the television that's on the ceiling, and there is a button here that says fold down. If I press that button, the television comes down, all the shades go up on the sides and the back to darken the back as much as possible, and then the television comes down and it is fully extended down. Then it turns itself on and tells you you are in your BMW theater. There is the screen, there I am on the left, and there's Tom on the right. Wave, Tom, there's Tom. Okay. So if you don't do anything with this pretty quickly, a timer comes up that says if you're not gonna use the screen, it's gonna refold itself. And we're not gonna do that because we are not running right now and this thing is a battery powered vehicle, but just wanted to show you that so you can see what it looks like. And it says good morning, it's greeting us. It gives you all these different languages, English, Spanish. There's a lot of languages on here, down to Portuguese.
I'll give you a $5,000 bonus if you can use one word in all those languages.
One word, English, no, I don't know. So yeah, there's a lot on the screen. You have an audio feature on there, inputs and display for the television screen, and Fire TV. And there's a lot going on here. We're not gonna go over all of that. There's also, you can control your speakers from here also. There's a speaker button and there's volume control buttons. You can just slide them right on the screen itself. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and go back to the screen. There's a fold up button. I'm gonna fold that, push that button and fold everything. The screen goes back up. All the shades come down to hit you back into the mode that you were in before. Up here you have grab handles on both sides and you have interior lighting right here. let me see if I can get to, let me go back to home real quick and show the seats. There's the control for the seats. They're not necessarily all that intuitive. Whatever part of the seat you want to move, you have to press that particular button, and then you have to press that arrow, and now my seat is going forward. You can't see it, but it is going forward. I push the back button, it goes back. Push the up button, the seat bottom goes up and down. And if you want to work the headrest, you got to press that button and then work those arrows. You can't see it, but my headrest is going up and it's going down. That's how you work those. There's also a button here where you can control the seat on the opposite side, seat number two. And this seat here, this button here is for the front seat, where you, if you press that button, you can adjust the seats in front of you also. Very nice vehicle. It's a great tour. I do like the technology in this vehicle, and you should come down to BMW of Shreveport and come check it out, and you should buy it.
And let's take a quick look at your charge port. Going to be right here. Again, pretty simple to figure out as far as what all is here. Easy to deal with. You've got your little controls right there to open things up. They're not power. They're just, you just release it and they come up. But you have everything for your different styles of chargers depending on what you want to use. Again, I definitely recommend that DC fast charger. It will save you a lot of time. Hear that sound? That is the sound that this BMW i7 makes when it's in reverse. Something that we don't always get to let you listen to, but we're going to try and give you the ultimate tour here. That needs to be part of it. Okay, before we move on, I know part of the ultimate tour is giving you the price of the vehicle. And so what exactly is that? $145,945. If you need the $5, I'll give it to you. Let's take a look at what we have on the passenger side door over there. And besides speakers, this definitely has a very nice audio system. And for that price point, it better. And one thing that's very interesting, I don't know how easily we can show it to you, is the size of that door bin. It goes so far back that your arm can just about get stuck in there. That's hard for me to get my hand or my arm all the way in there, but that thing literally goes all the way back as far as you can see with the material right there. And let's give it the old armrest test, see what Carrie says. That's what I expect. Very comfortable armrests here. We didn't do that in the back seat, but it's the same. And nothing out of the ordinary, but you'll have all of your different controls here as far as that goes for opening and closing the doors, but also the controls for managing your seat position. And that goes as a kind of a given. And obviously, power seats for the driver and the passenger. I should have jokingly said, you get a power driver seat, but a manually adjustable passenger seat. Everybody probably would have clicked off the video and said, you don't know what you're talking about. They don't understand when I'm joking. But here's what we have. And I do like the pattern here as far as what we have. It just kind of breaks things up. Personally, I'm not crazy about a black interior, especially here in Northwest Louisiana when it gets really hot. If you're wearing shorts and you're living back in the 80s, short shorts, you're going to burn your legs, probably. You don't want to do that. We'll hop on inside here now. There's a lot more to look at than just what we've looked at there. Let's take a look here at what we have. Carrie's going to close his door, and he likes playing with the features here. And there you go. You can see some of what we have right here. I really like that design. It's nice that it has that look to it that it does, where it's not just flat. Something that just breaks things up when you're looking at it from the right angle. It looks really nice. And if you're looking for how to open the glove box right here, you're saying, where's the release? It's right here. So I'm going to push that. Well, I say I'm going to push it. There we go. And it opens. Kind of interesting. There's plenty of space in there. As usual, no gloves, but at least you know what to do to get that open. And here with our infotainment screen, pretty easy to see. Hopefully the glare is not an issue. I think that's going to work out okay. Hopefully it will for you. You can see what's here. Pretty easy to deal with. You can go in and make several different adjustments. You can manage, well, everything you can imagine with the vehicle. If you want to go home, you can go right here. There's your navigation. That works out nicely. If you want to see all of the different icons for all of your different options that are available, well, here is everything for that. Obviously, you're going to have Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, as you can see right there. Everything pretty easy to figure out. Wirelessly connecting your cell phone, that should be a given. But you can see everything that is here. And I'll go into reverse real fast just so we can show you the camera. The rear view cameras, obviously, you have your overhead view right here. And then we have our surround view as well, where we can go and look all around the vehicle. There are so many different views here. Depending on what we want to see, well, we can see literally every angle of the vehicle. So pretty easy to deal with as far as that is concerned. And we'll work our way down here. I don't know how easily you can see. We're kind of dealing with a lot of glare today, just kind of hard to get rid of that. But you can see what all is here as far as the different buttons go. There's that button again, or I guess that's not really a button. It's just something that you touch to open the glove box. And we'll find right here that we have our wireless charging pad. We'll also have a couple of cup holders right there, as you can see. And then you can hide those away, which is very interesting. I haven't seen that in any other vehicle, I don't think, where you can do that individually. I like that. The action is really nice. It has a clean look to it. And then here is your start-stop button for putting power to the vehicle. I almost said starting the engine. That wouldn't have worked too well. But putting power to the vehicle before you push the power pedal and not the gas pedal. And your shifter right here. Kind of interesting because, well, I always want to grab something if the shifter is in this area. But you just work your way back and forth. Reverse, drive, and then we can put it back into. We put the parking brake on. It's going to go into park. And then obviously right here you have some one-touch features for your infotainment screen. So if I want to go to media or go to my phone, whatever I want to do. And we can also use the dial right here. That's actually kind of interesting because I'll let Carrie show you that if we can. You can see the sun reflecting off of that, hopefully. But if I want to select something, there's how I do it. I just push down on the phone. And you can see some of the other one-touch features that are here as well. Pretty self-explanatory as far as that goes, including what we have with the radio right there. And we do have Bombay doors right here. We'll open those up and show you what's inside. If you're wondering about USB connectivity, well, there it is. There's also a 12-volt power outlet right there if you want to take advantage of that. Kind of cigarette lighter style, but that is your 12-volt power outlet. And let's talk a little bit about getting into or using the power shade right here for the sunroof. Now, this is going to be a little bit different because here's what's going to happen. It's going to go about halfway, and then it's going to stop. Well, it proved me wrong that time. I guess I did it right that time. We've been having trouble with it stopping halfway. But you can see that it's just a solid piece of glass. It doesn't actually open and close, but easy to deal with. But you do have ambient lighting up there. And speaking of ambient lighting, in Carrie's driving lounge, we're going to pull inside and give you a better view of everything.
Hey, everybody, YouTube watchers and vehicle visionary fans. Carrie's driving lounge again today, BMW i760. There is a lot going on here, but we're doing an ultimate driving tour today. We're not doing any comparison to anything else. Let's see what's going on here. I'm going to start by opening this door. One of my favorite features is the touch that button and the door opens itself. I love that feature. But the reason I open the door is to show you that to close that door, there's a couple buttons you can push. This one here, you can pull the door. You can door close itself. But if you push the brake pedal, I'm going to do right here, and you hold it, the door will close itself. If you stop pushing the brake pedal, it will stop at whatever point that is. Pretty cool. Usual features here on the door, you have seat control, seat memory 1 and 2, and you have your button to control your seat on the opposite side, your door and unlock buttons, and you have your crystal knobs to control your seat adjustment here on the front. There's the button to open and close the door. And what does this button here do? Let's push that button and see what happens. I don't see anything happening, but it does something. Oh, that's the control for the vent right there. You have lighting, and you have light controls right here in the front, auto, off, on. Very nice. You have your window controls, front and back, child safety button right there, and your mirror controls, and there's a button there for your trunk release. There's a dead pedal, and there's your gas and brake pedal. Not gas and brake pedal, but your electric drive move pedal and a brake pedal. Here's your control for your tilt and telescope and steering wheel. And you have over here, nothing. A lot of ambient lighting in here. Look at this. Very orange. It's also in this roof. I don't know if you can see it there, but there's also ambient lighting lines in that roof. They don't show up so well where we are now. We'll try to go somewhere where we can show that. Steering wheel. This steering wheel is nice and thick. Feels very, very good in the hand. Very good in hand. Flat bottom steering wheel. You have your boost control right here for your electric drive. And you also have, let me turn this thing on. I think it's off right now. There we go. You have your turn signal, button, left, right, they do work. You should probably use those things. And you have your wiper controls on the opposite side for your fast, slow, intermittent, and your squirters to put water on your windshield. You have a mode selector right here on the right stalk of your steering wheel, three-spoke steering wheel, very sporty. You have a mode selector switch right there that you can turn. Nope, you don't turn, you push it up and down. And you have your airbag. This is actual a leather feeling steering wheel cover. Don't see a lot of that. It actually feels like leather. A lot of it's, there's hard plastic, it looks like leather. There's an M button right there, emblem right there. It doesn't do anything if you push it. Then you have telephone activation, up and down volume, and some channel control changers there. On the screen right here, let's see what we get. We have, there we go, the vehicle is now on, and the turning on the steering wheel, power assisted, very, very easy. We're sitting still, and there's no resistance from the steering wheel at all. Feels very, very good. There is augmented reality in front of us on the camera. You have, shows that your lights are on, park, shows your battery power range is 59%, the clock there, speedometer button. There's a temperature control on the right side, and it shows how much electric range we have right now, 174 miles. There's your power meter, and there's your speedometer, 160 miles an hour speedometer. So let's play around and see whatever else we can mess with. We have a home button right here. I'm gonna push this, and we're going to try. This vehicle requires a learning curve, let's be honest. I'm hunting and pecking my way through this because this is not set up like a usual, you know, gas-powered vehicle. A lot of electric features in here. So we're gonna just, you know, play with it a little bit and see what we can figure out, because if you come by a vehicle like this, you're gonna have the same learning curve. So let's hunt and peck through this. We have a home button right here. Push it and see what we get. There's a compass right there. Destination inputs for your map. And let's see if we can get BMW to help us out here. Hey, BMW, ambient lighting, please. And
try one more time.
Oh, BMW's not helping us out. There's interior lighting. And there's ambient lighting. And we can change the colors in here. There's an ambient lighting color deal right there. It best shows up right here in front of us. So let's go through some of those colors right there. You have yellow, and it changes pretty quick. And there's a light green color right there, changes pretty quick. A lot of colors here. Turquoise, I think that's turquoise. It changes pretty quick. Yeah, they're very nice. I think I would prefer some version of red. Is there a red in here? Let me see. There is a pink, looks pretty good. And you know, whatever you want to do in here, purple. And there's also ambient lighting in that roof up there. There's Tom back there doing something. I don't know what he's doing. He's waving, but he's doing something back there. And there are ambient lighting in the roof. I can't really see it from the driver's seat because I'm sitting right on top of it, but we'll try to go somewhere where we can show the ambient lighting a little bit better. There's the wheel, which is crystal. They call it crystal anyway. Crystal volume button for the radio wheel. And a crystal shifter right there. You have grab handles right here. And your seatbelt height adjustment is not adjustable. So whatever height you are, you have to adjust that through your seat. Again, there's a lot going on in here. Technology-wise, it does require a learning curve, but that would probably be a lot of fun if you buy this vehicle and you're into technology. My favorite feature for sure is gonna be the open the door button. I love this button. You press it and the door opens itself. I need that in my Mercedes. That's just so much fun. It really is. This car has made me door open lazy. I've only been with this car about an hour and I'm already lazy about, I don't even want to open the doors by hand anymore. I hope you enjoyed Carriage Driving Lounge today. Like and subscribe and share and all those kind of things. And we will see you next time.
And a little extra treat for those of you who stuck around to this point in the video. We told you we were going to try and get into a darker atmosphere to show you really the lighting up here in the roof area. Well, hopefully it's showing up where you can actually see it. I hope the screen is picking that up correctly. But that's not all that I wanted to show you. I also wanted to show you some stuff on the exterior. We didn't get to show you the kidney grille that is illuminated here as well. That was just about impossible to see outside, but you can sure see it here. Nice and bright LED lighting right there. That definitely does the job. All right, here we go on our test drive, and I want you to listen. I'm gonna get out here just a little bit. Here we go. Let's see what happens when we drop the loud pedal, the quiet pedal. All right, now I have to go to the hospital and drop Carrie off in the emergency room. Wow, very, very impressive acceleration. Not the most impressive of any EV I've driven, but I tell you what, I hope you heard the sound, because I probably won't get another chance to do that again on this test drive. We're just gonna have too much traffic around us, but you really hear it. That's pretty cool. And the acceleration is pretty good, and I know that everything is faster when you're not the driver, it's faster when you're the passenger. A couple of things that I did want to talk about here. Earlier in the video, we didn't talk about the fact that, number one, you have a head-up display. Very impressive, very nice. Not anything that's out of the ordinary for BMW, but it's here, and I like what we have. Something else is, while I'm sitting here and waiting for enough room, if I get it, to give Carrie another enjoyable experience back there when I drop the pedal, which I'm not going to likely get the chance, but if I did, the good thing about it is at the same time that I'm enjoying acceleration, I'm also getting a nice massage, because these are massage seats. So that works out really well. You have quite a bit going on. There's just so much here that it's impossible for us to cover every single bit of it. It's a shame that we're not number one in line here. Carrie's probably happy about that. Laughing in the back seat back there. He wanted to see what the acceleration experience was like from the back seat. I don't. He said it's the same as the front, so I guess we're good there. He needs a throw-up bag either way. We won't show that on video if it happens. You might hear it. I'll just have to edit it out or something. But what about the practical use here? Well, definitely an enjoyable vehicle to drive. Very, very good handling characteristics, and yet a very comfortable ride quality. It's nice when you can find a vehicle that balances those things, and that's definitely what this i7 does. So the ride quality will give you plenty of time without wearing you out when you're on a test or a road trip, whatever the case is. I mean, the range being about 300 miles, well, you probably won't want to go that far unless you can find a DC fast charger, because then it won't take as long to charge. But one way or another, enjoyable. Very, very high-end interior, not only with materials, but obviously with technology. The thing I like here is that the technology is very easy to learn and very easy to use. We mentioned that earlier in the video. A very well-balanced interior. I like that, because there's not anything here that isn't high-end, that doesn't look high-tech. I like the curvature of the screen, even though it doesn't really have anything to do with being high-tech, but it's driver-focused. That's always good. It just kind of gives that wraparound feeling almost with the way the dash is designed here. So you really have the best of both worlds in so many different ways as far as practical use, but also that great technology and the acceleration when you're in the right place to use it, especially for those of you who live locally and seem to struggle to understand what it means when you get onto the interstate and need to merge at a higher speed and you're driving 35 to get into a 70. Yes, I'm dropping another pet peeve. So tell me what you think about the 2024 BMW i7, besides being a mouthful to say. Hopefully we gave you enough details and information to help you see what's going on with this particular model. There's actually a lot more to show than we took time to show, but we didn't want to make this video too long. We do want to say a special thanks to our friends here at Orr BMW for loaning us this model for the day. Remember that link down in the description of the video so you can come in and buy this one, and then you can show it to your friends and say, my car is on YouTube. How cool is that? And a special thanks to each and every one of you for being kind enough to give us the opportunity to give you a vision for your next vehicle. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a like. Hit that like button, that helps us out a lot. Make sure to subscribe if you haven't done so already. That way you don't miss any future videos. And if you would like to learn about additional vehicles you may wish to consider purchasing, check out that video that's on the screen right now, and we'll see you there.